Good evening, everybody. We gather today for our Eucharist on the second Sunday of Ordinary Time in the Church's liturgical year. Special welcome to any visitors that are here this evening. Our celebrant tonight is Father Philip Sullivan. We leave behind the season of Christmas to journey with the Lord in the daily ordinary. On the journey is Jesus, our individual selves, and others we encounter. We journey shaped by our friendship with Jesus. We can describe ourselves as servants of God, apostles of Jesus, lights to others. We are part of the way God's saving power reaches to the ends of the earth. Let's pause for a moment of silence to still ourselves and to enter God's presence with loving and grateful hearts. Let's all stand for our opening hymn.
Thing about the liturgy of the church, it's timeless. We're in eternal mode, and also Saturday suddenly becomes Sunday. You'll get Saturday back in an hour's time. Isn't that good? But it's just that the presence of God that we are in, beyond time and space, everything. We come together in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. May the Lord be with you. Lord Jesus, you truly are the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, bring us to everlasting life. Pray. God, Father of heaven and earth, your watchful care reaches from end to end of the earth and orders all things in such power that even the tragedy of sin cannot frustrate your loving plan. Hear our prayer and show us the way to peace in the world. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives, who reigns as King with you, Father, and with the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Thank you.
This is a reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord said to me, "You are my servant, Israel, in whom I will be glorified." And now the Lord says, "Who formed me in the womb to be his servant, to bring Jacob back to him, and that Israel might be gathered to him. For I am honored in the sight of the Lord, and my God has become my strength." He says, "It is too small a thing that you should be my servant, to raise up the tribes of Jacob and to restore the survivors of Israel. I will give you as a light to the nation, that my salvation may reach to the far ends of the earth." The word of the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. From Paul, called to be an apostle of Christ Jesus by the will of God, and from our brother Sosthenes, to the church of God that is in Corinth, to those who are sanctified in Christ Jesus, called to be saints, together with all those who in every place call on the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, both their Lord and ours. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
With you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. John the Baptist saw Jesus coming toward him, and he declared, "Look, here is the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. This is the one. It is he of whom I said, 'After me comes someone who ranks ahead of me, because he was before me.' I myself did not know him. I came baptizing with water for this reason, that he might be revealed to Israel." And then John testified, "I saw the Spirit descending from heaven like a dove and remain on him. I myself did not know him, but the one who sent me to baptize with water said to me, 'He on whom you see the Spirit descend and remain is the one who baptizes with the Holy Spirit.' And I myself have seen and have testified that he is the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord. Last week, we still had the Bethlehem crib before us. It was ending the Christmas season. Jesus, the Son of God, was the infant king, and the three wise men from the East made this great proclamation of faith. Today, all of a sudden, Jesus is 30. Wonderful, isn't it? And see, people are saying this year is going to go very quickly. In 1 week, the church has made us do this leap forward. John the Baptist would be 30 plus 6 months. He's 6 months older than Jesus. And he's got a different title, Lamb of God. That's a very heavy Jewish rich thing. A lot of calories in that title. Historical titles of God's servants. And his mission is to take away the sin of the world. So today, John the Baptist, we can just call him a cousin. And these are very real and intimate ties, cousins. He puts Jesus on a worldwide platform. And he says to us, and we say it in every Mass, look, you know, are you awake? Are you going to miss this moment? Look. Now, these things in the Mass are commandments. They demand our attention. Yeah, our response. Look, here is the one who will take away sin, and no one else will be able to do it. So tonight, this is boring, but it's just a pity. You'll recover from it. I think it's worth having a really in-depth look at John the Baptist's pedigree and see how it is that he is capable of this great proclamation tonight that Jesus is the Son of God. He could see it, and so many others could not. First of all, there's the very close ties between Mary and Elizabeth, the mothers of those two children. And the great Rosary Mystery, Visitation, has etched that into Catholic belief and prayer and devotion. The Visitation. Luke tells us, the different gospel from tonight, that every year, get that, every year, Joseph and Mary and Jesus made the journey from Nazareth in the north to Jerusalem in the south. So that's Whangarei to Takapuna, 3-day journey in those days by camel or whatever, donkey. And they came to Jerusalem city to the big temple and the ritual of the Passover. So they were blessed that they could do that every year. Not everyone could. Now, can you imagine when they were down there, they would get together. If Mary in haste went to visit Elizabeth and Zachary and the whole household, when they came to Jerusalem every year, they would have caught up, wouldn't they? Try and think of the conversations between that went on for 30 years, years and years and years, that went on between those parents, Zachary, Elizabeth, Joseph, and Mary. Because they had been touched by God in a special way through the pregnancy of both of those boys, John the Baptist and Jesus. And they knew their child, those boys, had a destiny planned by God. And imagine the children at play. They get very bored with religion. Kids can't take it for hours on end like parents did. And they'd be playing, John the Baptist and his cousin, and other children. Wonderful things are happening. You just think of all these holiday visitors you've had, grandchildren meeting their cousins for the first time or once a year. It was part of my life, looking forward to cousins coming. I've still got them. It's a lovely thing in our lives. So John the Baptist and Jesus were part of this great big extended family, which in New Zealand is called a whanaungatanga. Isn't that a good word? You've got to work hard to get that word pronounced. The extended huge family. And we all know when we get together, we each have a place in it. And we've got the famous story of Jesus at 12. He stays behind in the temple, and Joseph and Mary suddenly realize, where is he? And they find him. And that's part of the rosary too. So these are chunks out of scripture that have been turned into wonderful mysteries of Catholic prayer. But Jesus is 12, and he's on the edge of adulthood. And it must have been exciting for him. I'll just give mum and dad the slip I want to stay and listen to these old people teaching. And he asks them questions, and he's got a curiosity that they can't work out. All in our holy scriptures. And he returns to Nazareth and back to his trade. We don't know. And John the Baptist, at some stage, he lived in the south. He goes out into the Judean desert for some time and lives like a hermit and wears dreadful clothes and eats hideous food, honey and stuff. And it's felt from the things he said that he was part of the Dead Sea Qumran community. There's another little snippet in here worth thinking about. Jewish scholars in those times in Jerusalem, this group of, they'd be big old men with beards, they used to go through the Jewish scriptures with their finger right to left across the page, 24/7 reading the promises of Isaiah, Jeremiah, Ezekiel, the whole lot, the big prophets, the little prophets, the law of Moses, and all the books. And why they were doing it was they're saying, we are keeping vigil, waiting, so that when the Messiah, the Christ of God, comes, we will see him. Our eyes will be sharp, our ears will be in tune, and we will be ready. And they're still waiting. So many didn't see it. And yet it was this cousin, John, and we heard it tonight, John the Baptist, the rough and radical kinsman of Jesus, he got it. And how did he do it? That wonderful fabric of family life. He knew him, and yet he still didn't know until late in life, 30, and his own study of the Jewish books of promise. And so he becomes the great herald, the last Jewish prophet, and he tips the Jewish era of waiting into the Christian era of fulfillment. And John said to the people, look, I'm baptizing you with water to get you ready for him. He will baptize you with the breath of God. And that's what happens every time we baptize an infant or someone old or in between. It is God's life poured in. The word and the water of baptism means God comes to live within you. Well, just as John the Baptist and Jesus spent every Saturday of their growing up going to the synagogue, hearing the stories, hearing the word of God, you and I are going to spend every Sunday this year. We're committed to it, aren't we? You've got to say yes. We are committed to every Lord's Day listening to these stories through this new year that's heading out. And to the gospel of Jesus, who has whose life, whose passion for life, his death and resurrection, has removed in him, has taken sin from the world and death from us. So let's just finish with some lovely thoughts that Pope Francis had for last Sunday. I think these are nice little, these are like the last of your Christmas chocolates. You don't like chocolates? They're good for you. Listen, here's the first one. Francis said this, set out today on an exciting new adventure to grow more and more in your faith. All right? Happy to try and do that? Be always open to everything that the heavens and the earth contain, and stay curious. It's all of God's creation. Let it speak. And this is a good one. Be aware of the struggle and the pain of other people around you. Yeah. What about this? This is one of those chocolates that are tough to chew on. Don't tranquilize your soul with easy answers to life's huge questions. This is big stuff. And finally, rediscover. Discover again and again the wonder and the worship of the Mass. Let there be occasional moments of deep prayer in our lives. And finally, like the wise men, give God your best treasures by loving Him and serving Him.
This is our faith. This is the faith of the Church. We are proud to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord. I believe in God.
Everlasting. We pray
that the Holy Spirit will empower our actions and our words so that all we do and say may bear witness to the Jesus who dwells in us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all volunteers who serve in the community and in the Church, that they may be blessed for their commitment to the welfare of others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all married couples, that God's grace will empower them to love in the good times and in the bad, and to grow stronger through journeying together in the daily challenges and delights. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For God's blessing on all our young people as exam results arrive and choices are made about their futures, that they may seek to use their talents in the ways that benefit human development and the preservation of Mother Earth. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all political leaders may be open to the stirring of the Holy Spirit, guiding them to lead their people in integrity of lifestyle and service to the common good. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families, that these summer days may be blessed with refreshment, time together, and joy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those burdened with illness and health problems, that they may be strengthened by God as they share daily in the passion of Jesus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us all join together and pray for Ukraine.
us pray that our sacrifice and our gifts will be acceptable to God, our loving Father. O God, help us to participate worthily in this mystery, so that the work of our redemption may be brought to completion through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty, our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks and praise, Father, almighty eternal God. For you, O God, so loved the world that you gave us your only Son to be our Redeemer. He was to live like us in all things but sin, so that you might see and love in us what you see and love in him. And so, Lord, we now, with the saints and with the angels, praise you as we acclaim. Indeed, holy Lord, you are the fountain of all holiness. Make holy these gifts by sending down your Holy Spirit upon them, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus the Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the chalice filled with wine, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memory of his death, his resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Stephen, our Bishop, and all your holy people. Remember our sisters and brothers who have died in the hope of the resurrection. Welcome them and all who have died in your mercy into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, St. Joseph, St. John the Baptist, and all the saints, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise you and glorify you through your Son, Jesus the Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. We dare to join with Jesus in his priestly prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, be thy name. Kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Temptation. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, who said, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church. Graciously grant to her peace and unity in accordance with your will, you who live forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with you. To those near us, Christ's peace. John the Baptist saw Jesus coming toward him, and he said, "Look, here is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world." Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. O God, you have fed us and filled us with the true bread from heaven. Fill us with your Holy Spirit to make us one in your peace and in your love. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. The only notice that I've got to draw your attention, they've got these little machine things at the door for if people want to give donations there, they are there. And how they work, but they're called, what are they called? Are they those? So they're at the doors, and if you want to use them, they're there. The year has begun, the working year has begun for most people, and the working year for the next the rest of it, Jesus will be at work rescuing us, rescuing all of us who are most in need. So good, a good beginning. Thank you. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you. Bless this parish, this night. The Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We go in peace to love and to serve our Lord.
Amen.